After overcoming the technical issues, we can start now. As the colleague already said, I'm Johannes Peter. I work for MediaMarkt Saturn Retail Group, and I'm a product owner and architect for the domain of search. Before I moved to MediaMarkt Saturn, I was an external consultant in different companies for search and natural language processing projects, especially in the context of e-commerce and enterprise search. So before I start with the presentation, I'm quite curious about how much experience you have with search application, or whether, or let's simply ask, who of you already had developed a search application or is currently developing a search application? Ah, quite a lot. Okay. So what do you experience to be the greatest challenges when developing a search application? Simply shout it out. Nice one.
Collecting the data.
Pardon?
Collecting the data.
Perfect. Okay. Any more?
Language.
Ah, okay. Nice. Yeah, of course. Sure. So I personally, this is only my personal opinion, of course, I experience the biggest challenge, as for every IT, all IT products, of course, the people, hiring, coordinating, educating, motivating, and the like. And I divided the challenges for the areas of e-commerce and enterprise search. I experienced scaling, the performance issues, campaigns, especially for e-commerce. Relevancy tuning can be very complicated. In the domain of enterprise search, access rights might also be a very big challenge. So to implement in the index who actually is allowed to see which kind of documents and who is allowed to be suggested several documents, especially. But I also experienced data extraction and from complicated source systems to be a big challenge, as well as transformation and collecting the data, as well as data enrichment. So, and actually in all search projects where I was involved and which aimed to develop a search solution, at the beginning we were not really discussing about search. We were discussing about how the data can be collected and pre-processed before it's actually pushed into the search engine. So the discussions about the topic of data pre-processing or data collecting actually consumed a lot of time. One reason for that probably is that data in many companies, managers and people who do the long-term planning expect data to be easily retrievable, well-structured, reliable, valid, and of course complete. But in the end, a lot of time is required and a lot of time is spent until the data is ready and is actually prepared. So, so what are the typical data pre-processing issues? For example, frequently the data has to be retrieved from different source systems which have different characteristics, probably also different security mechanisms for data enrichments. For example, several lookups have to be done. For instance, if you build an index is built in the context of e-commerce, you might extract the product data out of a product database, but the prices might be also relevant for the search. And as prices frequently change, they might be rather stored in a key value store. So after extracting the product data, there have to be done lookups on such kind of store. As data standardization is also quite tricky. For example, you don't want to phase it over all over the release dates. You actually want to phase it over aggregated release dates. For example, which products are already available and which can be ordered in the future. So there can be a lot of expensive operations. So there might be bottlenecks at some steps. And of course, scaling also is an issue. For example, if a lot of data has to be pre-processed, if there are big volumes, And also if there are if very frequent updates for near real-time search is required. So for all these issues are particularly challenging in the context of search, as most tools who are specialized on handling such operations frequently are only capable to handle structured data, whereas search solutions frequently or actually almost always have to handle semi-structured or unstructured data. And this is why Apache NiFi is very well suited for search solutions, as NiFi is capable to handle all these issues and does not make any assumptions on the structuring of the data, and it's principally able to handle all kinds of data. So, the logic of NiFi is actually fairly simple. It does not store data itself. It extracts data from somewhere, from some source system, for example, a database or Hadoop or a Hadoop store or a NoSQL store. It transforms the data and it loads it pushes the data again to a target store, for example, or Elasticsearch or Solr. And the data is shipped from processor to processors via so-called flow files, which consist of metadata and content. So the metadata is actually some data about the content. It's simply a key-value pairs. And the content is some kind of data. So it might be binary data, it might be JSON, it might be XML, it might be simply text, or the like. And flow files are processed or changed or created in so-called processors. At the right side, you see a data flow, and the bigger rectangles are the processors. So for example, there are processors to extract data, to transform it, and to load it. And each processor is intended to fulfill a designated task. So for example, extracting data out of a database is done by a certain processor, whereas pushing the data into Solr, for example, is done by another processor. So each processor fulfills one specific task. And the processors are combined to flows via queues. So actually, a processor processes a flow file and subsequently hands it over to the next processor in a queue. And the flow files are waiting in the queue until they are retrieved or taken by the subsequent processor and processed there. So, as NiFi has various processors to interact with other systems, you can imagine that you frequently have to deal with different kinds of data formats. For example, one source system might export XML, whereas the target system requires JSON or the like. And if it now were intended to build a processor for all kinds of transformations which are actually required to interact between different kinds of systems, there would be a lot of processors required. For example, if you would require a processor that transforms JSON to XML, that changes JSON to another JSON, that converts CSV to Avro, and so on and so on. But in the end, all these formats have in common that they usually contain several indivisible entries. So, for example, if you export XML or JSON, for example, out of a MongoDB, you will do that in batches, and you will have several indivisible entries that might be, for example, for an online store, your products. So in order to avoid requiring a processor for each of those transformations, NiFi provides an abstraction for data. So-called record readers and record writers are provided. So the entries are the record readers are considered to transform the entries, the so-called records in the data to serialize it to a standardized format and to an object structure, whereas the writers are intended to write those objects again to the data formats. And the advantage of this approach is that if a processor is implemented in order to do an operation on data, it can be the operations can be done on the serialized and standardized data and not directly on XML or on JSON, for example. So this approach enables to work a lot more generic with the different kinds of formats and allows easy transformation between the formats. And all the user has to do is to define a schema that describes the respective format. So for example, this is on the left side, we see some XML data that actually contains data about products, for example, described by an ID or by a manufacturer and the title that is embedded in another tag. And on the right side, we see the schema that describes that data. It's the same logic like Apache Afro works. So we define on the right side in the schema, we define the fields. For example, we have a field called with the name ID. It's of type string. And we have two nested fields, which their name is menu_s and the title. So, and this the schema logic is very generic, as JSON, for example, can describe in the same way. So, for example, we have a comparable JSON on the left side. So there are two products actually described, and the first is described by an ID, and also there are the manufacturer and the title embedded in the product product field. So all the user has to do is to define a schema for the respective data format. Then it is serialized. Then the NiFi runs several operations, depending on the processor on it, and it is written to a respective format again. So NiFi provides various out-of-the-box functionalities that can be done on the standardized and serialized records, for example, transformation, lookups in source systems, SQL that is actually executed on the records, validations, and typical operations like merge, partition, or split. So and to make it a bit more clearer, what this actually is about, I prepared a little showcase. So we have a data flow here. At the beginning of the data flow, data is retrieved. So in this simple showcase, simply a file is read from the file system. So we can activate the processor. Then the file is fetched. We can view what this is about. Probably a little bit. Yeah. So we see now this is the content of the flow file of the loaded file of the file we just loaded, and it's the same like I described before. It's some kind of XML with embedded product data, and it contains the descriptions of about two products. So what we are doing next is we load that flow file into a processor called update record. This processor is intended to read the XML data using a schema to serialize it, then to do some operation on the serialized data. In the end, those are simple mappings. So we want now that it that it retrieves the nested data and flattens it. So we don't want to have flattened data anymore. We don't want to have nested data anymore. We want to have flattened data, as for example, the data in the end shall be pushed into Solr, and Solr does not really like nested data. So the schema for this XML reader is the same like I just showed. So I will simply activate it. And we can see require some clicks. Now the same data has been transformed to JSON, and the fields are not nested anymore, so the documents have been flattened. So in the next step, we might want to enrich this data by prices. So for this paper, for this purpose, a lookup processor is defined for this queue. The lookup processor simply retrieves the value. It also, again, of course, it serializes the records. It retrieves the values from the IDs, and with these values, it lookups in a key value store. For my example, it simply does a lookup on the price. On a file, but it's to simplify it. So I will enable it, and we can again we see. Oh my God! Now I've made it too big. Yeah, there is some price data. So it simply took the value of the ID. And sent that to some kind of key value store and extended this to our documents. So, and finally, the data is pushed into a locally running Solr. And is made searchable here. So, this is a locally running Solr. Okay, it has a commit within parameter, so I don't know why it's not indexed right now. Oh, okay, some kind of exception, I don't know why. I don't know why it currently does not work. I will try again. No, it doesn't work. I don't know why. It used to work. No, I'm sorry, it doesn't work. So this breaks a bit my subsequent presentation. What I wanted to demonstrate you is that I would have changed this processor in a way that it retrieves files all the time and produces flow files all the time. And so I simply wanted to show a way to demonstrate a way to get rid of bottlenecks. For example, you can you can allow NiFi to use several threads for a processor. So actually, this is not embedded within the implementation of the processor, but it's a highly multi-threaded application, and so there are various ways to get rid of bottlenecks. So I see the time has run. So I will find the end. So as we finally can conclude that data flows can be quickly created, it's fairly easy to develop them. It's a highly customizable application. You can build and thread processors without knowing anything about threads, as the threading is done within the embedding of processors and not within the processor itself. It's highly scalable as it runs similar like Solr with a, it communicates with a Zookeeper ensemble and is can easily be scaled. It provides data provenance, so the processing of flow file is tracked for each step. So this facilitates debugging, and in the end, it's also well suited for search. It has various way to interact with Solr or Elasticsearch, and the interaction is supported by various processors. So thank you, and sorry for. that the showcase did not work as I actually wanted it to work.
Okay. You can meet him and ask questions in the coffee break. We wanted to invite you to the coffee break. We have cookies, so I hope that you enjoy it. Thank you very much. Thank you for your presentation.